In an interview with CNN's Jamie Gangel, the former Secretary of Defense, yet again taking aim at President Obama, claiming he is directly responsible for the rise of ISIS. Cheney and his daughter Liz, a former Deputy Assistant Secretary of State during the Bush administration, are out with a new book titled Exceptional: Why the World Needs a Powerful America. Here's a portion of what he had to say.
You in the book blame the spread of ISIS on President Obama. He says it's your fault that Bush Cheney left the region unstable.
Well, I think he's wrong. Look at the record. We had a situation in which by the time we got through the surge in 07 and 08, President Bush made a very courageous decision, very correct decision, and Iraq was in good shape when we left office. And Barack Obama said as much. What happened basically was they failed to follow through. They withdrew as quickly as possible and left no stay-behind force there. They created a vacuum, and the vacuum was filled by ISIS.
How dangerous do you really think ISIS is now to homeland security, American soil?
I think extraordinarily dangerous, partly because of their ability to recruit from the United States people to become members of ISIS, to go to Syria, Iraq, and so forth. I think the danger of having those people return, having trained, for example, over there, or their ability to motivate people in the United States and elsewhere in other parts of the world to become ardent followers, if you will, of that ideology and sacrifice themselves in the name of killing infidels, I think that possibility is increasing. And I think ISIS is very dangerous indeed, especially if you think about the prospects of nuclear weapons being developed in the Middle East.
Do you think we could see another major 9/11 style attack on American soil?
I think we could see another 9/11 style attack with much deadlier weapons. I worry if they use chemicals or biological agents or nuclear weapons. Remember, the weapon they used on 9/11, airline tickets and box cutters. That was a difficult, terrible day for us. 3,000 casualties. It'll be a lot worse if they find deadlier weapons.
Let's talk about the battle against ISIS with Democratic Congressman Adam Schiff, who is the ranking member of the House Intelligence Committee. Congressman, thanks for joining us. Your response to these dire warnings from the Cheneys?
Well, first of all, you've got to give the vice president credit for being able to say these things with a straight face, particularly to lay responsibility for the growth of ISIS and before ISIS, really al-Qaeda in Iraq, at President Obama's feet, when there's probably no one who is more of an architect of the disaster in the Middle East than Dick Cheney. But nonetheless, in terms of the threats that he's talking about facing the country, ISIS is really more focused on the quantity of attacks rather than the quality of attacks. They have not as yet tried to mount a major 9/11 style assault. That doesn't mean that can't change, and obviously we're very vigilant to any change in the nature of their plotting and planning. But I still worry more about al-Qaeda, the remnants, the franchises like AQAP that have shown more sophistication than ISIS in trying to pull off those big kind of attacks.